I'm Colin Singer, immigration lawyer and managing partner of Immigration.ca. Canada Immigration News Articles, September 2014. Where's the best place to live and work in Canada? Thinking of moving to a new city? Waterloo, Calgary, and Ottawa are considered the most attractive places to live and work in Canada, according to a new survey by the Conference Board of Canada. They're among the six cities that earned an overall A grade when ranked on such measures as education, environment, health, housing, innovation, and society. The other top performers are Richmond Hill, Vancouver, and St. John's, though Edmonton came in ahead of St. John's among university-educated workers. Toronto ranked 13 on the list of 50 cities, which puts it smack in the middle of the 14 cities that earned an overall B grade. Oshawa ranked last on the list of 50 cities the conference board ranked, just below Cambridge and Brantford. It was among 13 cities that drew an overall D grade. The report, called City Magnets, was to be released last Thursday. The assumption is that cities who fail to attract skilled workers will struggle to stay prosperous and vibrant. Canada's largest cities generally performed best in a category the board called Society. The category measures levels of population diversity, use of public transit, access to culture, and incidences of poverty and crime. Toronto, Montreal, Vancouver, and Ottawa were the top four on the score, followed by Markham, Richmond Hill, and Brampton. Each of these A cities has its own unique appeal, but they all share a diverse and strong multicultural base, the report found. Richmond Hill has the most diverse population, with 59.3% of its residents identified as foreign-born. Toronto was not far behind at 47.9%. Immigrants to Toronto have the worst economic success, however, earning just 61% of what their Canadian-born counterparts earn, the study found. Toronto offered the most options for commuting to work, with 46% taking public transit, walking, or cycling to work. This compares to just 13.7% in the car-dependent suburb of Brampton. But Toronto also had higher crime rates than the suburbs, roughly twice the levels. Montreal had the highest number of people living in poverty, while Toronto ranked 41st on that score. The results of the 2014 study largely reflect those of the 2010 cities report. Cities at the top remain there, cities at the bottom continue to struggle. For the first time, the study looked at whether university-educated workers have different criteria than less educated workers when choosing a new place to live and work. The answer was no. Source: The Star.